Hi. If you are a developer looking for jobs in Silicon Valley companies, stay with us till the end. This video is going to change your life. Hello and welcome to Turing Developer Diaries, a series where we walk you through the amazing lives of Turing's remote family. I am Alina Khan, tuning in from Gurgaon, India, and I shall be your host for the day. Have you always wanted to work for Silicon Valley companies? Do technologies like React Native, Node.js, Flutter pique your interest? Are you wondering how you can clear job interviews of these in-demand skill sets? Hang on, my friends. Wait till the end. Today, we have a very special guest joining us who will answer all of these questions. And we'll also learn more about React Native, Flutter, and also the skills that top American companies look for when hiring developers. Turing, a leader in the remote workspace, is a platform that connects Silicon Valley companies with brilliant pre-vetted remote engineers from across the globe. If you want to know more about the company, you can have a look at their website. The link is mentioned in the description below. Without further ado and without further delay, let's welcome Dhyey, who is joining us from Gujarat, India. Dhyey has degrees from institutions like IIT, one of the best engineering colleges in the country, in India, and the University of Toronto. He has worked with big names like Amazon, and today he is the React Native Tech Lead at Turing.com. Hi, Dhyey. Thank you so much for joining us today. How are you doing? And I really hope that you and your family are staying safe in these tough times.
Hi, Anila. I'm doing great. Thank you for asking. Thankfully, me and my family are safe here. How are you?
I'm doing good too. Thank you so much. Now, let us talk about you, Dhyey. You have quite an accomplished career behind you, and you have so many accolades in your pocket already. And I am sure our audience would love to know more about you. So let's begin with a quick introduction. What is your story?
Sure, yeah. So I started my undergrad at IIT Indore, and then I transferred to University of Toronto to gain access to better resources. And over there, I focused on different areas of AI, like machine learning, natural language processing, and computer vision. I made sure that I got a solid foundation in an upcoming technology, which is AI, to prepare for a stable future in the industry. During my time there, I interned at Amazon at their Seattle headquarters in my third year. And after graduating, I received their full-time offer and joined the Toronto office, where I stayed for 2 years and got the opportunity to work with and learn from some of the best engineers around the world.
Okay, that's pretty interesting, and that's quite an interesting story. But it would be wrong to say that I'm not intrigued with the sudden shift that you made in your career from a leading e-commerce company to Turing. What compelled you to take the leap, and how has your experience been since then?
Right. Working and learning at Amazon was great. I felt I wanted to be in an environment where my work would have a larger impact, especially on the company level, right? Moreover, I feel that people tend to lose connection with each other and the company's mission as a whole when we are working in a larger corporation. And I just felt that working in a startup with a close-knit culture would be an ideal situation for me. I returned to India to stay with my family, and I live in Gujarat. So I did not want to relocate to a tech hub like Bangalore or Hyderabad, right? Then that would just defeat the purpose of moving back to India. I chose to be a software engineer for the very fact that I could work from anywhere, right? And at the time, that is convenient for us. We are not required to be present at our office like other professions, right? That's why I started to search for remote opportunities and found Turing via a Facebook ad. The idea of working for a great US company from the comfort of my home felt like a dream. And I watched the vetting flow of Turing, and today I'm here.
Sounds like you are having an amazing time at Turing, and it's very exciting. And which brings me to the next question, which is, how has your experience been this far with Turing?
Working at Turing has been great. I joined in January 2020, and I have seen Turing grow from a small company to a pretty big 200-person-plus company over the year. And I feel that's a result of extraordinary visionary leadership and the work of talented engineers. I got to interact with teammates from all around the world, which is not possible in in-person environment, like in a physical environment. And I just don't need to elaborate how awesome working from home is. Comfort and convenience at its peak, right? Plus, I save a lot of time and energy in not having to commute to an office. Moreover, I feel that working remotely is very important, especially during this pandemic, where there were lockdowns, people were getting laid off, but my job, it wasn't impacted at all. I was able to work from my home, and the most important thing is I did not have to put myself or my family's health at risk.
I think that's pretty great, you know. And I would also like to emphasize the fact here that working remotely is definitely an advantage for everybody. The time that you save on commute, you can actually invest that on hobbies, and you can actually do a lot more with that time. Now, Dhyey, you have been at the organization for 16 months, and I think you would have a fair idea of how the interview processes work at Turing, especially because you interview React Native software developers. So I would like you to walk us through the interview process, the vetting and the matching process, especially to give aspiring developers an idea of what they would be required to do.
Sure. The process begins by signing up and creating a profile with as many details as possible. Right? The more information a developer puts in, the better chances are of them getting matched, because that way we have a much better understanding of their skills. After filling up the profile, the developers need to choose a type of role that they're applying for. And after that, they are recommended some automated tests that they should take in order to be qualified to apply for the job. And again, there is no limit on the type of test they can take. We have more than 100 technologies, right? So they can take as many tests as possible. And again, more number of tests they pass, the higher are the chances of getting matched to a job, because the number of jobs increase, right? And after they pass these automated tests, they are directed to a live coding interview. This is the place where they meet me or one of my teammates, and it's a coding interview, as it says. They are presented with up to 2 questions, and they need to solve them within 30 minutes. Passing that stage would mean that they are now qualified to be matched to high quality jobs for US companies. We do have a second type of interview as well, which is the fast track interview. And again, we are continuously improving our processes and making them more efficient to meet the demand.
Okay, the fast track interview that you just mentioned, I think our audience would love to know more about that as well. How different is that from the regular track, and who all are eligible?
Right. As the name suggests, fast track interview process is the shorter way of passing our vetting flow. We have certain roles that need to be filled quickly, either because they're high priority or they're time sensitive. Thus, we need to skip the regular flow, which can take a while depending upon how fast the developer takes those tests and passes them. And then we directly invite senior engineers to apply for the fast track process and appear for an in-person interview. This process is like a 1-hour one-on-one interview. And in this interview, we cover a lot of topics that are usually covered by the entire vetting flow funnel.
That sounds very interesting. I'm sure everybody listening to us would have already applied to Turing. If you haven't, please click on the link in the description below to head on to the website. Now, coming back to you, Dhyey, we have learned about the interview processes. We have learned about the fast track process. Let us now talk about React Native, which is your expertise. We see that there is a constant competition between React Native and Flutter, both of which are frameworks. So when it comes to in-demand skill sets, especially the ones that are required by US companies, what do you say? What should developers learn to stay on the top of their game?
Right. Today, yeah, again, many startups as well as even large corporations are choosing to develop mobile applications using cross-platform frameworks like React Native and Flutter instead of developing the native apps directly. This is because it allows the companies to develop and test their MVPs much quickly. Right? And even in the long term, this is much easier to maintain because it's a single code base. And definitely, Flutter and React Native are some of the top contenders for cross-platform frameworks. But I believe that React Native has the edge here because firstly, it's backed by Facebook. And so we know it's really reliable, it's stable. It's being used by some of the very big companies like Airbnb, Instagram, right? And moreover, one of the reasons for its popularity is that it uses JavaScript, which is one of the most popular and loved languages right now. Right? Other than that, I feel that React Native has the edge because it's older and more mature. So it has a stronger community. So finding help, finding third-party modules would be much easier than doing that for Flutter.
Now, Dhyey, let's assume the developer sits for a Turing interview and he clears all the rounds. Okay, what does his career path look like now? Could you give aspiring developers a broad picture of what they should be looking at?
Sure. Working with Turing has the benefit of going through the vetting process only once and getting matched with multiple jobs for a long period of time, right? Rather than the traditional way of having to go through numerous interview rounds for every company you apply for whenever you're looking for a job change. Once you are a vetted developer on our platform, you are matched to a light US-based company. And once that engagement is over, our matching team quickly finds another high-value client that you can start working with. So this way, your work and consequently your pay does not get impacted while waiting for a project. Right? And all of this is from the comfort of your home. Moreover, Turing's tests are some of the toughest tests for these technologies. So you can proudly say that you have passed these tests and you belong to an elite group of top 1% developers.
That sounds like an amazing reason of why everybody looking at us and listening to us right now should apply to Turing. Here, I would like to add and emphasize the fact that Turing has job opportunities with elite US organizations in 100 plus technologies. If you believe to be confident in the skill sets that you possess, you can apply to Turing today. Head on to turing.com/jobs. Coming back to you, Dhyey, we have often heard that the interviewers in general ask developers to be skilled and to be well-versed in the basics of the language that they are aware of and that they are skilled in. So when it comes to React Native, what are the key topics a developer must brush up before they sit for the interview?
As I mentioned earlier, in a fast-track interview, we cover a lot of topics that are usually covered by a lot of different stages across our regular vetting flow. I mean, one of the most important things is to have hands-on coding experience. They need to be prepared to write some code and explain how it works. So just writing some code won't matter if they cannot tell me what they're trying to do, right? Apart from that, inside-out knowledge of the technology that they're applying for is absolutely necessary. And at Turing, we look for experienced and accomplished developers. And for that, they need to be able to show that they have a mastery over the subject. Other aspects that we look at are knowledge of how applications are designed, on a higher level, right? So thinking at a larger level would definitely help. Different stages of the software development lifecycle. And we also judge how a person would work with a team. So we need to make sure that the developers we hire are good team players.
Okay, I hope all aspiring developers here are taking notes, because these are some very important points that you should take care of before you sit for any interview. Now, Dhyey, let's assume that you have to draw parallels between the ones who cleared the Turing test in the interview and the ones who didn't. So what was that one striking difference that you have noticed between the two?
To answer in one word, I'd say preparation, or the lack of it. Developers need to realize that an interview is a golden opportunity, and if they squander it, they're not going to get it back, right? Passing an interview would mean that this would change their work and even how they grow, at least for a couple of years. Hence, they need to prepare well for the interview. And as I mentioned earlier, hands-on coding skills, as well as knowledge of the particular stack that they are applying for, are the most important things. And I've often heard developers saying, oh, I did not know this was going to be in the interview. Or, oh, I'm sorry, I did not prepare for this. So that is something that makes or breaks the result of an interview. Another thing that we look for in developers are their communication skills. And again, at Turing, we require the candidates to be able to express their thoughts clearly in English, as well as understand what someone else is trying to convey to them in a written or an oral form without having to repeat. Again, experience with the technology surely plays a role in the interview, but that is not something that we can change overnight. So focusing on the other areas like being prepared and communication skills are some of the most important things that determine the result of an interview.
Preparation for sure is important, be it for an interview or be it for even a live coding test, I think. It is very important. Thank you for sharing that, Dhyey. I think and believe that all aspiring developers would have a fair idea of what a Turing interview process and a Turing test process looks like. And I think this has been one hell of a ride. I am sure our fellow developers out there would be intrigued to head on to the website by now. But before we let you go, Dhyey, we would like you to give one final advice to everybody listening so that they can prepare for their job interview better.
Sure. Again, I would like to stress on the fact that preparation is the key to passing an interview. We don't ask anything that a developer using the technology would not know, right? But the fact is you have to be confident about your skills. And honest about the things that you don't know. Saying, I don't know this, but I'm willing to learn is better than giving a wrong answer, just for the sake of it, right? And yeah, you shouldn't think of an interview as a test, but it's a discussion where we are trying to understand how your abilities are and how we can make the best use of it and provide you with the best opportunities.
Amazing. Thank you, Dhyey. Thank you so much for being here with us. And thank you so much for joining us today for this session and for sharing such valuable piece of advice. We are glad to have you as a part of our ever-growing family. And we hope that this interview reaches the larger developer community and helps us give out many such great opportunities to developers like you. To everybody out there, we'd be happy to answer any and every question that you have. You can email your queries at support@turing.com. Let us know who you would like to hear from in the comment section below. Give us a big fat thumbs up if you like this video, and we will be back with many more such Turing developer stories. Till then, stay safe and click on the link in the description below to apply to Turing. Happy working!